Buffalo Maine Channel viewers. Welcome to Be On the Boards, your all-access pass to the University of Maine hockey scene. I am Matt Schimberg. We'll be joined by Joe Haggerty and Sean Sullivan in just a little bit. But the Black Bears are gearing up for another run at the Frozen Four this year. But to make that happen, they're going to have to get through the Hockey East, a very tough conference in the country. So guys, let's go down the list and see what the Black Bears have to look forward to this season.
All right, well, the University of Maine started off their season. They felt like they were in trouble. They lost two games right in a row to Denver. They came back to UMaine. They played two games in a row against Mercyhurst. They had to win both games. They did. Last weekend, they went down to Northeastern. They really wanted to take at least one of those games. Really, they'd love to have two, and they took two. They got both of those games. And they were worrying about, are the rookies going to step up? Well, with Jeff Dimon and Tanner House scoring this weekend, along with great senior leadership to back them up, I think they are going to step up this season, and they're ready to make that run at the championship, Sean.
Yeah, definitely. We saw Dim step up this weekend as a defenseman. He played real smart hockey from what I saw at Mercyhurst. It's great to see a kid like that score. You know what? The Black Bears played strong defensively. They only got 13 penalties in two games, where they had 73 minutes coming into the game, which, I mean, that's a big cut down for them. And real smart hockey. Bishop played well again. Hockey East co-player of the week. And now we're going to get to the other teams in Hockey East.
Moving down here, we got Boston College. They beat Merrimack 7-1 on Friday. They're 3-1-2 on the season. Now, guys, Boston College, a really tough opponent for University of Maine. How do you expect them to match up?
I like BC. Well, I don't like BC, but I like their team. They're stacked head to toe. They've got great freshmen, and they've got great senior leadership. Joe Whitney, he's a freshman. He scored 6 points this weekend by himself. A couple of their older guys, including Matt Green and Tim Flangieri, also had big weekends. And their freshman goalie, John Muse, is really beginning to take shape. He stumbled a bit at the beginning of the season, but week to week, he is coming along. How do you think they're going to play UMaine? How do you think UMaine's going to have to play them to win?
You know what? Corey Schneider's shoes are big shoes to fill, and their freshman goalie's doing a great job with that. But you really got to look out for the offense with this team. You got to look out for the shots. You got to protect Bishop. You got to shut down junior forward Nate Gerby, who has been just phenomenal ever since he's been a freshman. This is a really strong team, and they're always going to be a contender. That's what we know from Boston College, and it's going to be a good matchup for UMaine, I think.
Absolutely.
Now, the University of Vermont, they're also in the Hockey East. They're 0-3-1 in the season after losing to Dartmouth over the weekend. Now, guys, you think Vermont is going to be the classic cellar dweller of the Hockey East, or you think they can actually do something now?
Well, I think they're going to finish off near the cellar. They've got one thing, and they've got a lot of it, and that's heart. And I'll tell you what, that's going to help them win games this season. I don't like where their record stands right now, and I don't think it's representative of their team, and especially of their fans. They've sold out 60 of their last games in a row at their stadium. That's big. They've got support, they've got people rooting them on, and they've got a good young team.
Yeah, this is going to be a team of momentum, and any momentum they can pick up from anywhere, especially their fans and their support around the campus, is going to be great for them. Vermont's a new team to Hockey East. You know, it's tough to get involved in this league with the level of play that everyone's playing at all the time, and the defense, the hitting. I mean,
Hockey East, perennial powerhouse.
Right, they were a good team in their previous conference. I believe that was America East, and yeah. And you know what? They just really need to get used to playing Hockey East hockey, and I think they will do that. And by the end of the season, we could see them somewhere in the middle of the field.
That's very interesting, Sean. The Boston University Terriers, they're 0-4-1 in the season. Is this a surprise to you guys, or is this something that you expected out of the season?
Well, it's not really a surprise to me, Matt. See, BU lost their star goalie, John Curry, and with the loss of that goalie, you lose a lot. You lose confidence. Your defense can't play as well because they're worrying about skating back for the puck. Your offense doesn't feel like it's wide open like it should be. I don't think they're going to have a great season. I don't even think they're going to finish top five Hockey East. What about you, Sean? How's UMaine going to have to stack up to play these guys this year?
You know what? Jack Parker, great coach at Boston University. He's been there for years and
years.
And he's going to know how to turn this team around. What it's going to be is really getting the team to trust each other. Once these guys really start trusting each other, these young players start trusting their freshman goalie, they'll be able to turn everything around. I think, you know, they're going to play in the Beanpot this year in February, and they always tend to do well in that. So that's going to be a good way for them to pick up momentum heading into the Hockey East playoffs. So look for them to make a run real late, and hopefully they can perform better than they are right now.
We'll see.
Now, guys, the University of No Hardware, a.k.a. the UNH Wildcats, they're unbeaten right now. They're 3-0-0 after beating Colorado College over the weekend. Guys, do you expect them to stay on top of the Hockey East, or how are they going to do later on in the season?
Well, that was big. They took those two games against nationally ranked Colorado College, and that just really has them steaming full bore ahead. They're 3-0 right now. They're one of two teams in Hockey East that hasn't lost a game this season, and they are stacked. I like their team. They've got a great offense, a great defense, And they're ranked fourth nationally right now.
Yeah, you know what, Joe? I don't really like their team, you know? It's a very strong offensive team, but that's not going to get you through where you want to be. Playing a team like Maine with guys like Bishop making saves, and you're going to get pounded by kids like Brett Tyler and Matt Duffy, and you're just going to get hit all over the ice. Once your offense wears off, UNH has nothing. They really don't have anything to back up that offense. That defense has never been strong. Even with the experience of these guys getting older, they have never learned how to play real defensive hockey. So, you know, I see them maybe really finishing real high in the regular season, but once it comes playoff time, don't look for them to be too hot.
Well, I think with the play of guys like senior defenseman Brad Fleishman, he scored 4 points over this weekend, and I mean, that's helping. Their defense is coming around, I think. My personal opinion, they're going to be a Frozen 14 this year. Sean's opinion, maybe not so much.
But again, you mentioned defensemen scoring goals, and that's not playing defensive hockey. That's just a defenseman stepping up as a forward like we see some of our guys do sometimes.
Yep. But
well, that's an interesting thought, guys. Hopefully, Sean, I hope you're right. The University of New Hampshire never seems to do well in the playoffs, but we're going to take a break here. Coming up, we're going to finish this conversation on the Hockey East, including previews of UMass, UMass Lowell. We got Providence coming up to the bottom of the barrel, maybe. We'll see. We'll be back. Superman, that oh, yeah, why me crank that Robocop? Super friend, I why me jump, jocking on them, hate them, man. When I do that, soldier boy, I lean to the left, they crack that thing. Now, you, I'm jocking on them. Welcome back to Beyond the Boards. We're right in the middle of a Hockey East discussion right now. We're going to look at UMass Amherst. They lost to Providence 3-1. They're all even across the win loss tie column, 2-2-2. What do you see UMass doing this year, guys?
Well, UMass is playing great hockey right now. 17 players on UMass have scored points for the team this season. That's big. You can't just key on one guy at that team, and that's going to help them win. Right now, they're ranked 20th nationally. That doesn't really say, I mean, that doesn't say much for them. They could be higher. They could be lower. They're a team that's going to have to prove themselves late. They're 2-2-2, like Matt said. Sean, what do you think they're going to have to do this season?
You know what? They had a big loss last year, and Jonathan Quick, their goaltender, similar to the situation that we find Boston University in right now. Except Amherst is really making a better situation out of it. We see a team with a lot of speed coming out and a lot of young players, and guys are scoring goals. They're excited to be playing in this league. They're excited to finally get going, and I like to see what they're doing right now. It's good for the league. It's good for the entire nation, actually, to see them in the top 20, so look for them to finish in the middle of the pack, and you know what, they could make a run eventually, but yep. I don't see them finishing top three in Hockey East, but they could be anywhere in the middle.
I've got them in my top five. I actually have them at number five.
Yep.
But they could go either way. They could actually finish down there, eight, maybe at three.
Well, the other University of Massachusetts team, the Lowell Riverhawks, they beat Alabama Huntsville 4-1, and they are doing better. They're 2-0-1 on the season. And do you see them maybe doing a little better than the Minutemen, or do you see them falling off later on?
Well, aside of UNH, they're the only team in Hockey East right now without a loss. I think that's going to change soon. They're a great team with a lot of young talent, but they're not excellent. They're not ready to step up to that next level. I have them finishing in the second half of Hockey East. I don't think they're going to be big contenders, but I think they're going to be a fun team to watch, that's for sure, and I think they're going to maybe make a run in the next year.
Yeah, similar to UMass Amherst, they have a lot of guys scoring. I believe they have 15 different scores on the year,
exactly.
But they're a little different. They're not really a balanced team. They're just kind of guys that had no expectations coming into the season, and it's really easy to play that way. They finished at the bottom last year, and so no one really thought of them as really a contender this year. So they came out excited. They didn't really think they really had to prove anything. And now that they're kind of at the top, I don't really see them continuing this hot streak. They're going to probably end up falling off and finishing the bottom three of Hockey East again.
Yeah, I'm maybe six, maybe seven. They're definitely a team that they're revolving around. How is our young talent going to pull out the end of the season? How are they going to come along? If their young guys really step up and they continue to play the season like they've been, who knows? Maybe they'll be top five. Doubt it.
Yeah, it's tough to stay excited, but they've been excited so far. So, I mean, we can see what happens.
Here we go.
Not to mention that they have no seniors on that team. Also, a team that is looking to improve is Northeastern. They lost to Maine 3-2 and 4-3 over the weekend, and they are 1-3-0 on the season. Do you see them continuing this losing streak, or could they get better, guys?
Yeah, Northeastern is struggling. They're 1-3. They're off to a rough start. They're actually a team that's been a perennial power plays. They've actually had the most power plays in the last three seasons. They just settled down this season. They're really coming along, I think. What they did was now, right now, they have the least amount of power play minutes this season. That's big. That's going to help them out, but I don't see them doing much this year.
Yeah, nor do I, Joe. You know, they played Maine this week and they got swept, but they kept the games close, but the games were closer than they really were. I mean, they weren't very impressive this weekend. The second game, Maine blew kind of a three-goal lead late in the game. They let in two late goals. They really just blew Northeastern out of the water this weekend. It was really expected. Northeastern's not going to be very strong in Hockey East right now.
Yeah.
Look for Maine to just run them over.
Northeastern actually outshot UMaine both nights, but I think with that, that's really a testament to how good Ben Bishop is and how important it is to have a great goalie like Ben. Also, Northeastern's really going to have to start picking up the garbage. When they do have those plays, they're going to have to put the rebounds in the net.
Yeah, getting outshot is also kind of might be lackadaisical play against a team that you don't expect to be very good, but Maine won the game, so I guess it doesn't matter.
That's all that counts. W's.
Now, Merrimack, guys, they lost to Boston College 7-1 and 4-2 over the weekend. They're 3-2 on the season. After starting out 3-0, they pretty much expected that to happen. Do you see them going anywhere, or do you think they're just going to continue to dwell around the cellar, as we like to put it?
Yeah, I really don't see them going anywhere. I have them finishing below 500. They did have a hot start, but look who they played. Teams like Bemidji State. What I do see them doing is tinkering off really quick here. Like I said, I don't see them finishing past 500. BC really outed them this past weekend. They beat up on them both games. I think they only scored one goal in one of them to BC 7. So they were outshot something like 9-10-2 this past weekend. Yep. That is not where your organization wants to be.
Yeah, as far as Merrimack goes, I don't really see them doing much. I don't think that they're better than any team in Hockey East. I mean, even the guys that got off the slow starts are teams that are going to come around and be good. But Merrimack always kind of has a tendency to just fall off. And I don't know if that's coaching or if that's motivation or what, but either way, they really need to try to get this team going. This program needs to be getting better if they want to stay in this conference. I mean, they can't really compete if they're going to be at the bottom of the cellar every year.
I agree with you on that statement that if they want to continue in the Hockey East. And rounding out our discussion here is the Providence College Friars. They got their first win on the season after beating UMass 3-1. They're 1-4-1 on the season altogether. Do you see them moving up any, or are they going to continue to be with the Merrimacks, the UMass Lowells in the Hockey East?
Yeah, actually, their record is 1-4-1. I don't like that. I think they're a better team than that, and they're really starting to show it. Their first three games, they didn't score once on the power play. Their last three games, they've scored 6 out of 14 tries on the power play. That's big. They're really starting to step up. I think their leadership is starting to come around, and believe it or not, I've got them finishing top five here. I think they're going to do it. What about you, Sean?
You know what? Tim Army, he's a great coach down there. He's running this program real good. We saw him make a goalie switch this weekend. He pulled Tyler Sims for his younger goalie, Simcox, there. And this kid, if he can step up, he can carry this team. I mean, you talked about leadership. They got some older guys, but they also got some younger guys that really want to be playing for this program. And this team's got a future.
Yeah, I really think they do. Goalie Chris Manx, he was the co-Hockey East Player of the Week. He shared that with Ben Bishop. I think they're going places. I think they're going to finish above 500, probably around the 650 mark. But it's going to be good enough for number five in Hockey East.
Yeah, they'll definitely contend towards the end.
Absolutely.
Now, guys, after talking about Hockey East all this time, I got to get your predictions. Who do you think is going to finish out the top three?
All right, let me give you my top three first. I got UNH coming in first. I don't like them. I've stated it before. But they've got a good team, and I got to pick smart. So I got UNH coming in first, I got UMaine coming in second, and I got BC coming in third. If UMaine's got to play UNH in a Frozen Four, UMaine wins. You know it. I know it. What about you, Sean? What do you got? Tell me your top three.
Same three teams, but a different order. I see Boston College winning the Hockey East, being number one at least going into the playoffs.
That definitely could happen.
You know what? The thing I see about UNH falling off is that they're going to lose series to Boston College, and they're going to lose series to UMaine, and that's going to hurt them in their Hockey East standings.
That is true.
I have UMaine at number two, just like you do. They're a real strong team this year. They'll go into Hockey East strong, they'll go into the national tournament strong, and they'll make another great push. And UNH at third, they're just going to fall off late. They're going to lose some big series towards the end of the year. And you know what? That's really, really going to hurt them.
Yeah, as far as the regular season goes, I see UNH playing well. I see them finishing well. When it comes to playoff time, Frozen Four, I think UMaine's really got what it takes, and I think they're going to be the team that steps up.
Yeah, Hockey East Championship, I think it's going to be BC and Maine, and it should be a great game.
Go Maine.
Well, thank you very much, guys. Excellent job on the analysis. Now, after the break, Joe Haggerty got a chance to sit down with Jeff Harris, the leader of the Maniacs. We'll have that interview coming up for you right after our break. Stay tuned. This is Beyond the Boards.